Hey everybody, it's Amrinder Singh.
Today we're gonna look at why are you struggling with speaking Punjabi. I'm gonna give you four reasons. I think maybe this is why you are struggling in speaking Punjabi. Before I start the lesson, I wanna let you know that I'm gonna make a next video about how to learn Punjabi from nothing to fluent. I will upload that video in next few days, so you can subscribe the channel and press the notification bell button so you can get the notification when I upload that video. So let's get started. So first reason is probably you never tried. Maybe you are shy. Maybe you are scared of somebody. I don't know, man. Actually, you never tried in my opinion. Maybe you learned some vocabulary and you learned some words. Maybe you learned some how to greet people. But you never go far. You always stay your comfortable zone, I think. So this is the reason, I think. Another reason could be maybe you're shy and you think when you're gonna speak and other people are gonna judge you because you're gonna make mistakes. So if that is the reason, I think you should start speaking, right, with people. If you think you're shy, you can just speak to yourself when you're alone, and maybe you can record yourself and listen it again. And making mistakes is not embarrassing, so don't be shy. It's very natural. When you learn something, you're gonna make mistakes. Maybe you think when you're gonna speak and other people are gonna laugh at you. I don't think most of the people care about that. Maybe there would be some people who are gonna laugh at you. That's okay. It's not embarrassing. You can also enjoy with them. You can also laugh at yourself. When I was learning English and people were still laughing at me because when I was making mistakes, and I also enjoyed it. I wasn't embarrassing. I know it's so fun, and I was accepting my mistakes and I was asking them to correct me. So even I still make some mistakes and sometimes people laugh at me. It's okay. It happens. It's not embarrassing at all. So anyway, at the beginning, start from the small sentence like main thak gaya, which means I'm tired. Main football khedi jana, which means I'm playing football. After that, you can move to more difficult sentences. So second reason is you might be still struggling with speaking Punjabi is you quit too early. Maybe you were so excited at the beginning and you start learning from the vocabulary, then probably to start speaking. But after a few months, maybe 1 or 2 months, you got bored and you stopped studying, you stopped practicing. Maybe you thought it's too hard to learn Punjabi because you were practiced for last maybe 2 or 3 months and you couldn't improve much. And you got bored and you quit. No guys, that's not gonna happen in 3 or 4 months. I think you need at least 1 year, maybe 2 years. It depends how much time you give to this language to learn. So to fix this problem, I think you need to give time to yourself. Give at least 1 year, all right? And another reason could be you are not taking it seriously. Probably you study for a few days, then you stop for next few days, then you start again for a few days. Sometimes you study for 10 minutes. Sometimes you study for 4 hours. After 4 hours, maybe then you don't look at Punjabi for a month. That's what you're doing. So in this case, you are not consistent. So consistency is key to learn any skill. So you need to be consistent in learning Punjabi. Make it one of your priority. If you decide I'm gonna study for 1 or 2 hours of Punjabi every single day, then do it, right? Yeah, I understand sometimes it happens, we can't give a time. Yeah, you can maybe take 1 or 2 days off if you are busy, then back next day, okay, back to your schedule. Maybe you decided to study for an hour, maybe you have 30 minutes, then don't skip it. Study for that, even it's 30 minutes, or practice for 30 minutes. It's good than nothing. And make sure, maybe if you are busy for 2 days and you can't study for 2 days, remember back after 2 days. Sometimes what happens, like when we skip 2 days, then like we skip more days, right? That's what happens. We can't be consistent like that. So end of the day, you need to be consistent as much as possible. I think last reason is very big, because a lot of people are facing this kind of problem is like you're focusing too much on a formal Punjabi. Guys, there are a lot of differences between textbook type Punjabi and spoken Punjabi. Textbook type Punjabi, I mean a formal Punjabi, all right? If you're learning from a book, maybe from a teacher who teaches you a formal Punjabi, you won't able to understand Punjabi because we speak so differently. For example, if I give you an example of present continuous tense, right? Like in books, you would see like main football khel raha hun, right? It means I'm playing football. Main football khel raha hun. But that's not how we say it. We say main football khedi jana ga. All right? Did you see the difference? This is why you can't understand us. So guys, you need to learn informal language more than formal. If your goal is to learn conversational type Punjabi, then focus more on informal. The people speak, right? The way people speak. So definitely you can subscribe my channel, because I'm gonna make more videos about like what is the difference between formal and informal Punjabi. Guys, share this video with your friends who are trying to learn spoken Punjabi. At the end, I hope you enjoy the video. And if you want to learn about like how to speak more natural Punjabi, then you can watch my that video. Link is in the description.